are staying on top of major breaking news in Atlanta. Here's what's new. Fires burning at businesses into the early morning after protests turned destructive.
We're better than this as a city. We are better than this as a country. Go home.
And right now, Fulton County is under a state of emergency. We have live Team 2 coverage all morning to show you what's happening right now where you live.
Live, local, link-breaking. This is Channel 2 Action News, Saturday AM. Coverage you can count on.
It has been a long night, and thank you for being here this morning. Good morning to you, and thank you. I'm Fred Blankenship.
It is 6 a.m. right now. Good morning. I'm Linda Stouffer. I hope you and your families are home safely right now. There has been so much going on overnight. We're making sure you didn't miss anything. But first, let's get you caught up on the very latest.
And right now at 6:01, Fulton County is under a state of emergency after protesters started looting from stores and set fires across Atlanta.
Governor Brian Kemp called in at least 500 members of the National Guard into Atlanta.
And we know there has been looting at Lenox Square, Phipps Plaza, and the College Football Hall of Fame, and many other businesses as well.
And we are all over this for you with live Team 2 coverage. As you can see, we have four reporters getting a look at the damage left behind this morning.
And Linda, first we start with Channel 2's Chris Jose live in Buckhead. And Chris, there is glass pretty much everywhere where you are.
Glass everywhere, Fred. In fact, this is the quietest we've seen it all night long. We're here right across Lenox Square at this shopping plaza anchored by Pearl Vision here that you're seeing, and also an AT&T store. But look at all the glass down here on the sidewalk. People use these concrete blocks to smash the windows here, smash the doors. You can see here the store is wide open. I'm just going to watch my step here to show you around a little bit. Here's the glass. Look, the store is wide open. You can see there people came in here, looted the business, destruction here, damage here inside the building and also outside the building. Let's walk down here the sidewalk a little bit. Dana, watch your step. Right here is the AT&T store. I can tell you there was a crew out here who left about an hour ago, boarded this whole building up. You can see here, again, damage all across the sidewalk here. Look at all the phone cases on the ground. People came in there, looted the business, stole a whole bunch of phones, other electronic types. And then a little bit further down the sidewalk here, we had this dental care office. Also more damage. I'm not sure if you hear it in the background, but we hear that fire alarm going off. It's kind of reminiscent to when I worked in Denver, Colorado, when I worked the Aurora Theater shooting. It's the last time I heard an eerie noise just like that one here. Look at there. You can hear the fire alarm going off, and then also the water inside this office building. Looks like the sprinklers may have gone off. I can tell you there's also this distinct smell of smoke still in the air. And as we walk this way, it looks like the alarm has come from this business here, the Sleep Number store. Look at that. Not only do you have damage here on the ground, there's flooding on the ground. This mattress here has been burned up. Lots of damage that we're seeing here, not only in this shopping plaza, Fred and Linda, but really across Lenox, in and around Lenox Square. I can tell you we've seen a big police presence out here patrolling the streets. But again, this is the quietest we've seen it here all night long. Reporting live in Buckhead, Chris Jose, Channel 2 Action News, Saturday AM.
All right, Chris, thank you very much. And, you know, it strikes me as we look at the damage there, Chris was just showing us, Atlanta typically does not have situations like this. Chris, thank you very much.
And hopefully the calm that you see now will hold today. We told you it all turned violent yesterday evening in downtown Atlanta, right in front of the CNN building. Our live Team 2 coverage continues with Steve Galbach there right now. Steve.
And this was really the epicenter from last night. They've now cleared out. It was maybe 10 or so police cars that were burned up here on Centennial Olympic Park Drive in front of CNN. And we got here about an hour ago. We can see National Guard troops across the street. This is right in front of McCormick and Schmitz at Marriott and Centennial Olympic Park Drive, where there was looting. That has been boarded up now. If you look just down the street, more troops here will be here all morning long. And things have dispersed, have calmed down. But this was a very long night out here. And this is just a little bit of what we saw. From smashing windows to looting to setting fires, the night ended in downtown under a haze of smoke. Protesters set fire to more police cars just outside Centennial Olympic Park, then later burned out a kiosk building inside the park. After many arrests, and quoting Atlanta police, officers endured nearly constant assault, including protesters shooting BB guns at them, throwing bricks, bottles, rocks, and knives. Officers eventually deployed tear gas to disperse the crowds near the corner of Marietta Street and Centennial Olympic Park Drive, and it seemed to work. We saw police in riot gear, even officers in from other counties helping clear the streets. But a number of businesses are looted, and Atlanta's waking up to destruction downtown. It's hard to explain here. The whole street just littered with debris, glass, and trash. And it's like this all over Centennial Olympic Park down here. Now, Atlanta police waiting for an update this morning on the number of arrests, number of patrol cars burned up, and just the amount of destruction. Now, there are a number of businesses here that were broken into and looted. We're going to walk down the road and kind of take you back to some of the places we showed you overnight there, and we'll check the College Football Hall of Fame and bring you any updates there and have another live report in the next 30 minutes. We're live in downtown Atlanta. Steve Gellbach, Channel 2 Action News, Saturday a.m.
And Steve, I see those cars behind you. It's a workplace for a lot of people who have to go to work on Saturday morning. Steve, thank you.
And right now, we want to take you through more video from overnight. You can see the protesters smashing police cars with whatever they can get their hands on, like barricades and skateboards. Just a chaotic scene out there. You see the cars just right there in the middle of the street, and everybody walking around them. Some using the barricade gates and just putting it right over the front of that police car there and scraping back and forth.
And it is such a shame because police had told demonstrators they'd be okay to stay there as long as it was peaceful. Take a look at this. You can see an explosion from inside a police car already up in flames. All that black smoke as it was just going up in the air. And people so close to that fire. That was just outside CNN Center. The flames and the smoke just pouring out of their car, which just made it all the more tense and concerning for the safety of everyone there. Atlanta's mayor did not hide her anger. When she addressed people, she said, "We're disrupting what started as a peaceful protest." She told those who were still out last night, "Go home."
We are better than this. We're better than this as a city. We are better than this as a country. Go home. This is not the legacy of civil rights in America. This is chaos, and we're buying into it. This won't change anything. We're no longer talking about the murder of an innocent man. We're talking about how you're burning police cars on the streets of Atlanta, Georgia.
And sadly, it continued for hours after that. Mayor Bottoms also talked about her role as a mother. She spoke as a mom and a mayor. She said she understands the frustration people have right now when it comes to the safety of their black children.
We've been monitoring new video coming in overnight showing some of that violence. The Channel 2 anchor Sophia Choi is live right now in the newsroom. And Sophia, people are posting on social media what they saw out there.
And Fred, it really is hard to watch what looks like looting in our city. Take a look at this video. James Prince posted on Facebook. It shows people running out of the Aiden Jewelers on Peachtree Road in Buckhead. Mr. Prince took this video from a balcony and he watched what looks like looters running away from that store. Now, one major incident from overnight, the fire at Del Frisco's in Buckhead. We were live on air this morning as firefighters responded after someone torched it. And look at what Atlanta Fire Rescue posted on Twitter, video showing their damaged trucks with windows broken out. The department posted this video about 1 this morning as crews were cleaning up after responding to that fire. And we are seeing new videos like that being posted on social media. I'm going to be culling through them all morning long to bring you what we find. If viewers have video they want to share with us, they can send them to me on Twitter at SophiaWSB or to our WSB team by sending your videos to PIX@WSBTV.com. That's at SophiaWSB. Or PIX@WSBTV.com. Now, before I send it back to you, Fred and Linda, I just want to take a moment and share what I personally witnessed driving in at about 3:30 this morning. It was so eerie. The Brookhaven Police Department, as I drove by, had a parking lot just full of patrol cars ready to roll out. Not usually like that. And as I got closer to the city, Midtown Atlanta, it's what I heard that really got my attention. Lots of sirens going off. So eerie, Fred and Linda.
It's something that you, as you mentioned, Sophia, you don't normally expect to see. It's not a part of our norm, and we're going to try and work our way through this morning. Sophia, thank you very much, and of course, we'll keep checking back with you throughout the morning. And from News Chopper 2, you can see where the protesters eventually made their way onto the downtown connector.
That's between 10th and 14th Street. Now, that caused a big disruption at the time, but the protesters did not stay on the interstate very long, but you could see they had to make sure that they had enough space and no one would endanger them. It definitely stopped traffic behind them. First responders all night into the morning had to be ready to go at a moment's notice to react to anything as it moved from downtown to Buckhead. Here's a look from the bridge above the interstate where you can see those protesters out in the middle of the connector right there, people honking their horns as they were out in the middle.
And it's such a busy night on the streets of Atlanta. We want to check on the traffic impact for your Saturday morning.
People want to feel safe. They have somewhere to go this morning. Our live Team 2 coverage continues with Mike Shields, live in our 24-hour traffic center.
Hey, Linda. And yes, we're taking a live look at Traffic Tracker 2. This is right outside CNN Center, Centennial Olympic Park at Marietta Street, where Steve Gelbach is. Look at all that debris on the roadway. You can also see National Guard troops stationed on the corner there. Luckily, we're not seeing any protesters or anything violent happening right now, but we are keeping an eye on that. Also keeping an eye on what else is going on across Metro Atlanta. Let's take a look at our maps, including roadwork blocking three left lanes getting into Midtown. This is I-85 southbound right at Georgia 400. Currently no need for an alternate, just use caution. Also heavy roadwork on the south side perimeter. Multiple left lanes blocked. 285 eastbound, the outer loop getting past Riverdale Road. Live in the traffic center, I'm Mike Schultz, Channel 2 Action News, Saturday AM.
Okay, Mike, thank you. And a live look right here from one of our DOT cameras in downtown Atlanta. You see a lot of glass basically in the street right there. This is Centennial Olympic Drive at Marietta Street. Nobody out there right now. Very calm. Good to see that.
And a much different scene from hours ago. Thousands of people gathered. Then some protesters set fires and damaged businesses. We're getting all new video of damage as the sun comes up. Our live Team 2 coverage continues next.
I'm tracking drier weather, and in the days to come, we'll continue to heat up. I'll let you know when we'll approach 90 degrees. Closed.